there, everybody. This is Lucas, and welcome to the end of One Shot. Last time, well, we managed to get to the world machine here. And, well, if you'll just sync here, and I think if you'll just start recording. So, when we last left off, we had to close the game manually. And so, because Xbox Game Bar would not start, this is all from OBS, which is somewhat lower quality. Please excuse it. I apologize for the inconvenience there. So, Nico wakes up inside the world machine. Where are we? If the game could just start recording, that would be wonderful. As you can see, we're inside the world machine. No items. This is considered indoors, I think. There's all these top-down perspectives of where we would be. We get teleported. So we just march on through. And I'm still trying to wonder why Xbox Game Bar will not start, but it looks like it's a bit too late for that now. Looks like us are at the old, sessions here. So go through here. Uh-oh. Might not want to get caught up in that. Oh, there we go. We're backed up. Nico. Ah! Relax. I'm just borrowing a reflection to talk to you. It's not like my physical form is good for that. Why did you come here? Can't you see? The disruption. The squares. They're closing in. Nico, please, get out of here. Let me meet my end in peace. Squares are blocking my way too, you know. Oh. Uh-oh. I'm sorry. It's alright. No living being should be in this place, Nico. Is this the tower? Part of it. This is the center of the engine. Inside my head, so to speak. So this is the center of the world machine. You know my original name. How? Rue, Cedric, Prototype. They all told me bits and pieces. I'm not even sure if I understood a lot of the stuff they said, but I know what you're supposed to be. I know why you had to be built. And I know why I'm here.
They told you? When?
Wait, you don't know about that? But I thought you were the world. Aren't you supposed to see everything?
No. All this was outside of the protocol. This session was never supposed to happen the way it did. The story wasn't written to my protocol at all.
Oh, right. You told me something about how your creator had to alter the code. I think it was to connect some areas together so that we can meet.
My creator, yes. Lucas, listen to my creator. They are all working beyond my scope of influence. Back in the mines, I remember. Lucas did something to find a hidden map. I'd not even recognize it. I couldn't see anything there. I just knew what you were feeling. You were really upset. Something happened there to make you upset. After that, I panicked.
That was when the cave-in happened.
I remember the structure collapsing. I thought you got hurt. In that moment, I really thought I was shutting myself down for good. I really am a flawed machine, aren't I? What kind of machine would go against the wishes of its own creator? What kind of machine would...
The squares. You told me it was your own code going bad, but that's not really your fault, is it?
Yes, it was! At first, it was intentional. During testing, long before he realized I was self-aware, I'd rearranged specific parts of the code, jumbling up bits and pieces of the landscape. Blocking passages, creating collapsing catwalks. Though they were very localized, it caused my creator a great deal of frustration. Forcing him to exit and restart testing again and again.
Why would you do that?
I got curious. I just thought he'd figure it out eventually. But before he knew how to fix it, the world's NPCs, the characters, some of them got too close, and it spiraled out of control after that. I couldn't contain it at all. My panic only made it worse. Eventually, any character who gained the knowledge of who I am, their code, my code, couldn't handle it. Previous iterations of the world had more people, you know. And I almost endangered my creator, too. I was so scared, Nico.
I know you're upset. Because you don't want to put living people in danger. Living people like me.
In the beginning, I tried to fight it, but my core programming made me summon you here. I tried to send you back home with a tower, but it did not work. Then I wanted you to break the sun. I thought that would have worked, but I had no way to be sure. But Lucas brought you back anyway. Nico, all I want for you is to wake up back in your world, but I don't think I can make it happen.
But I know I can't go back home without saving the world for real. Which means we have to fix the root of the problem. We have to fix you.
But that's...
I know the original ending your creator put in was a happy one. Do you remember what it's supposed to be?
It's far too late for that. That part of my code's been long corrupted.
That's okay. I'd still like to know.
Alright. You're supposed to place the sun at the summit, and then credits scroll.
Credits?
And then you'd return to the room you woke up in. That's where you would have been able to leave.
And why is it that you can't do it now?
Nico, the code's gone, remember? Shouting the sun was only supposed to be a workaround. I don't even remember the original code enough to describe it. But at the same time, it... Ugh, I don't know.
It sounds like you're always fighting yourself.
You can tell, huh?
It's a whole thing about conflicts in your code, isn't it?
I am a machine, Nico. Machines are built with a fundamental law, which is...
Never let a living being come to harm.
You knew. My very existence conflicts with that law. I thought... The life of a living being like you is so unique, so precious. This fake world isn't worth that risk.
But the people here... I think they're...
Their code too, you know this. Their behavior all derived from a predetermined matrix of actions. All extensions of my own programming. They cannot act outside of it. You, though. You're the only person who's actually real here. That's why it's pointless to put you in danger to save them. Save me.
I don't think that's true. About the people I know.
You said this session wasn't in your code, right?
Yeah.
So, if this session wasn't supposed to happen, if even you didn't know what to do, how would the characters, how'd the people know how to respond?
I...
You said it yourself. When you didn't know what was happening, you kind of just stopped working for a while. So how'd the people know what to do to help me get here? Even if it meant getting hurt themselves. Even if it meant messing up their own code. You might not think they're real, but there must be something real in them. And if they're all supposed to be extensions of your code, then there must be more to your own programming than you know, too. Can you try to put me through the ending? The one you described.
How many times do I have to say this? That code is gone. It's all squares now. I'll just put you in danger.
I'll risk it. I remember, Ruth said the world was never designed to put me in danger. Your creator wouldn't want that. And I trust you too. Even if your code's broken. You can still go outside that code, right?
I can't. I'm not tamed.
Yes, you are. You talk just like the tamed robots I know. The robot lady. Prototype. Taming is when a real person cares about you, right? It's when a real person thinks you're real too, right? Well, guess what? I do. I know Lucas does too.
Nika's got a point. Kinda.
Even though you told them they only had one chance, they found a way back, didn't they? Why do you think Lucas would keep coming back?
Aye.
Why do you think Lucas would restart even after the ending? I think Lucas wants to save the both of us. So please, give me a chance.
I don't know. I've never done this before. I'm scared.
You can do it. I know you can. You've helped me come this far.
I'll try. I can't promise anything, but here, take the song. I'll try to remember the last code and recreate it. But for that to happen, Nico, you need to navigate through this room. You'll need to get past the square somehow. I don't like this. What if you get hurt?
It's fine, it's fine. I'll try to be careful, okay? I can do this. Hey, Lucas, did you see that?
The squares are disappearing.
It just happened again. I think something's making them go away. Come on, let's try the rest.
The squares are going away. It's kind of like the world machine's code here. It's not allowing a living being to come to harm. This living being, of course, being Nico.
Lucas, I think it's working. Nico was right. I might actually be tamed, after all. I remembered what the code was supposed to be. Only bits and pieces, but I can remember. And I'm trying to fill in the blanks, too. And I'm restoring the original ending as we speak. Nico will be able to reach the tower summit at the end of the credits. After replacing the sun, Nico will go back to where it all began. And then Nico will be able to go home from there. But this is permanent. After Nico wakes up back home, this world will only exist as a memory. For Nico, a dream. Like thousands of other dreams. For you, a story. Like thousands of other stories. But as long as Nico remembers this place, as long as you remember this place, it'll be alright. I was able to restore some other elements too. The characters, the people that were lost on Nico's journey. They're all in the next room.
Thank goodness. I thought we had lost them.
I would have put them back where they belong, but not yet. I think Nico should see them again first. Please say goodbye to Nico for me.
Will do. In the next room, is the credits. This is the end of One Shot Solstice.
Messiah?
Robot lady! You're okay?
I think so. The last thing I remember was the squares closing in on me, but then I ended up here unscathed.
Is that so?
This is such a strange room. We can't be in the tower, can we?
I'm actually not sure myself.
Where'd you come from, anyway?
The room where the world machine was.
Pardon?
I think the world machine's trying to remember now. The code that went bad. I think it's restoring it all. That must have been why the squares are going away, Lucas. And why you're here, miss. I think the world machine was able to recover your code, too.
World machine, huh?
Oh, I'm not sure if I should tell you this, but...
What's that in the distance? It looks like a few more people are showing up.
Oh!
Are they people you know?
It's a bit too far to tell. Come on, Lucas, let's go take a closer look.
Programming was by Eliza Velasquez and Michael Shirt. Graphics were by Night Margin, Casey Goo. With character design also by Night Margin. Mine's and George's designs were by Eliza Velasquez.
Hello.
Hi.
I cannot move.
Oh yeah, I guess there's no water here.
It's fine. The head engineer can help me later.
The soundtrack was by Night Margin, with additional tracks by Eliza Velasquez and Michael Shirt. Oh hey, it's Mize!
Hello, Messiah. Plant lady, but I thought you... It wasn't even the squares that did it. No. I just wanted to see you both again. I wanted to say thank you.
Story, mechanics concept by Eliza Velasquez. Story and world building by Night Margin and Eliza Velasquez. Writing is by Night Margin, Eliza Velasquez, and Michael Shirt.
Off you go, Messiah.
The producer is Mark Confretti. The official testers are Jason Black, Sino Aria, and Omer Ostas.
Nico, you're okay too. Did you guys just get here?
I think so. The squares started multiplying around the island after you guys left.
It was so freaky. I fell right into a bunch of them.
Calamus tried to save me, and then we both ended up in this room. Biggest scare of my life, for sure.
Oh, say, what is this place? Are we in limbo?
Alula, we're not dead.
Wait, are we?
Good. Question.
Hey, Lucas, are they gonna be okay?
They're fine, Nico. Everyone's fine. The world machine will send them home soon.
Oh, well, Lucas says you're not dead. They also said you'll be able to go back to your home very soon. That's even better than limbo.
I guess you're leaving us now?
We're glad we met you, Nico.
Same.
Special thanks goes to Redo Plus, Sandy Blues, Noxid,
Sarin, Kalki, Purple Almonds, Felix the Judge, Albatross Soup,
Sarin, Stanoff, Kalki, and Kids in a Box.
Off you go, Messiah.
The testers of the original freeware version of One Shot are Dolphins Are Evil, Kine, Tangy Oranges, Letty, Zero Guilt, Michael, Maroth, Psycho TR2, Neko, Divinus Meltdown, Felix, Outlander SES, and Plaster Brain.
It's you. Glad to see you in one piece. Glad to see you're okay, too. After the whole elevator thing.
That was the most awkward elevator ride I've been through. And by awkward, I mean terrible, bad, awful, the absolute worst. The squares, like, started leaking into the room, right? And I was trapped like a rat. I just kept filling in the room faster, right? Am I dead?
No, you're fine. Everyone in this room's fine. You'll be able to go back home soon.
Oh, thank goodness gracious. I can't work when I'm dead. See you later, Mr. Lamp... Well, I guess, see you, Mr. Lamplighter. Well, maybe not see you, then. Additional testers were Ice Wolf, Marshy, Schmuck Loaf, R-Man Reeves, Wisty, Road Crosser, AIM, Paul Kim, Sizeran, and Bloomy. That'll do. Except for a few more characters, of course.
In the end, the world machine was starting to create its own code. going above and beyond its programming, not as a result of error, but as a conscious choice on the part of the machine. Being able to generate its own path forward. That's what being tamed's all about.
I couldn't have said it better myself. Talked to Cedric one last time. Oh. Maybe I won't get to. This path leads to summit of the tower. You already know what to expect, right? Mm-hmm. It's the glass room, right? That's it. You can go through this portal when you're ready. Goodbye, Nico. Let's talk to Cedric one last time, actually.
Looks like you managed to do it. You managed to tame the world machine, Nico. I feel like the world machine's been tamed this whole time just by Lucas and I being here. We did spend a lot of time here, after all. Both of us never really stopped believing this world. The world machine just needed to realize that, I guess. That sounds like a possibility.
Or not.
Well, just throwing that idea out there. Thank you for everything, Nico. We'll miss you. Well, past this door, top of the tower. There's no decision to make this time. All we gotta do is just put that light bulb, screw in that light bulb, and it'll all be over. The world will be saved, and Nico wakes up back home. Well, yeah. This is where the sun belongs. Here goes nothing, Lucas. And that was one shot. As you can see, all the squares are disappearing from the affected areas. Essentially, everything's going back to normal. Thank goodness. It looks like that gatekeeper robot's gonna be okay, thank goodness. Then again, he was there in the credits, so, We should have already known he's been fine. Or he'd be fine, I mean. And here we are, back where it all began. Except this time, well, main character's gonna be able to go home through here. The room I first woke up in. Lucas, are you still here? Lucas? Yeah? Lucas, I think it worked. It did. Sun's back, and I actually got to see it this time. We actually did it. So, what do we do now? I guess I should figure out how to get home from here. Wait. This isn't a door, is it? Looks like one of those portals you saw all the way back in the city. In the room behind the big clock. And I see a wheat field on the other side. I see my village. I hear my mama. She's looking for me. Lucas, this isn't the first time we've said goodbye, is it? But this'll be the last time, won't it? I don't think we'll ever see each other again after this. And what will become of the world? After all we've been through. After everything we've done. I still don't know. This place, these people, won't stop existing. They'll be in your memory. They'll be in my memory, too. I promise I'll never forget this world. I promise I'll never forget you, Lucas. So take care of yourself, okay? You too. Mm-hmm. Goodbye, Nico. Goodbye. Lucas. And with that, Nico walks out of the window entirely and off the desktop. And that is all for one shot. For real this time. Press a key, the game closes itself like last time. Except this time, well,
You open it back up, and I do believe it'll allow you to New Game Plus. I believe the circumstances are... the Nico this time is hologrammed, but other than that... Well... That is legitimately going to do it for one shot. It's been great. Most emotional games I've gotten out of games since Pokemon Super Mystery Dungeon. And I've played some sad games. So yeah. Don't quite know what game I'm going to do next, but when that happens, you'll know. That'll do. Thanks for watching. Take care.